الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، وما بلغ البدز الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in his noble book the meaning of the verse: whatever the messenger has given you, take it, and whatever has warned you and guessed, stay away from it. Likewise, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the hadith which is collected by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim, may Allah have mercy upon them both, on the authority of Ummuna Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that the messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam said, whosoever introduces something is not from our affairs, it will be rejected. It will be rejected. So therefore, my dear brothers, may Allah bless you all, before we carry out any act of worship, as we have mentioned previously, we have to fulfill two conditions. The first one, our action has to be sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one, our action has to be in accordance to the sunnah of the Rasul alayhi salatu wa salam. And when we say to the sunnah of the Rasul, not the sunnah which is the opposite of al-mahba, غير الواجب, something is not wajib. No, sunnah is wajib. Meaning you have to follow Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam. Because some people, they think sunnah mean it's up to you to do it or not. No, sunnah means here is you have to follow it. If you don't follow it, your actions will be rejected, will be not accepted, it will be returned, will not be valid. So therefore, we have to learn and make sure, because otherwise, if you do an act of worship, it opposes the sunnah, it will be what? Al-bid'ah, innovation. The messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, during his lifetime, there was no innovation, no bid'ah. Every khutbah used to warn against a bid'ah. Every khutbah, not just every khutbah, in his speech, when he used to carry out marriages, marriage services, he used to warn against innovation, the bid'ah. Why? The scholars mentioned to show us the danger of innovation and bid'ah. And the scholars mentioned this is a refutation against those when you refute some Muslims, because some Muslims, they think you only refute the kuffar, the non-Muslims. No. Likewise, the Muslims who are upon misguidance and the callers to misguidance will refute them based upon the Quran and the Sunnah. And these do have the Quran and the Sunnah, and they have the Sahaba and Tabi'a Atba'a Tabi'een. If you don't like it, then brother, why are you debating Christians? Why Christianity be corrupted? Because Christians, they never defend their religion from the beginning. They see all brothers and sisters who keep quiet about each other. The Sahaba, alhamdulillah, from day one, they used to defend Islam against their own families, their own brothers and sisters, for the sake of protecting Islam. Because protecting Islam takes over protecting a Muslim's honor. Now you protect the Muslim's honor, but if a Muslim is known to call to misguidance, it's upon the Muslim scholars and the student of knowledge to warn against him individually with name. And this dua and the sunnah of the Salaf to protect Islam. And if you're not happy with that, you have to doubt about your Islam. If you're not happy for Islam to be protected, yes, you do it with justice. Don't lie against him. You're not even allowed to lie against the kuffar. Don't lie against the non-Muslims. Let alone lying and slandering the Muslims. Barakallahu feekum. So the shahid is that when you refute some people, some Muslims say, "Akhi, he's not even here." Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned against the bid'ah, was not even bid'ah there, to show us the danger of bid'ah. The shahid, barakallahu feekum, we live in a time when the bid'ah became sunnah, and the sunnah is bid'ah. Na'udhu billahi min al-khudlan. So my dear brothers, there is a nice story which is narrated by Imam al-Darimi, may Allah have mercy upon him, in his Sunan. Once Abu Ayyub al-Ansari was in Kufa, and he entered into the masjid. He entered where? Into the masjid. He found a group of people, someone in the middle, and throwing stones. Say to the people, say, Subhanallah. People, they repeat after him, Subhanallah. Another word, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Imagine one of us enter up in the masjid, and you found a group of people, and someone with the stones throwing it, say, Subhanallah. You think, Mashallah. Good brothers, Mashallah. Good iman. But look at the Sahabi. Sahaba, that's what Allah praised them. That's what Allah gave them victory. Because they're not deceived by your action, by the apparent. No, they have mizan, they have a criteria, Quran and Sunnah. So Abu Ayyub Ansari, he went back to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud to tell the story. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said to him, go tell them to count their evil deeds, for indeed their good deeds will not go to waste. Then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud went to them and he rebuked them. This is refutation against Sufiyya. Otherwise, Sufiyya, they have to see Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he's in Islam al-Iyadu Billah. Because Abdullah ibn Mas'ud knows this small bid'ah, because dhikr al-jama'i, to do a dhikr in group, if it was good, Prophet Muhammad SAW would have done it. Likewise, Sahaba, but Abdullah ibn Mas'ud knows that small bid'ah will lead to major bid'ah, as Imam al-Barbahari mentioned in his Sharh al-Sunnah. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said to them, what are you doing? They said to him, we only intend good. He said, how many people intend good and they never reach it? I cannot see you or me from the people that the Messenger of Allah has warned us against. And guess what happened to the majority of them? They became Khawarij and they fought against Ali ibn Abi Talib. From the dhikr of Allah, which is all of us, we think, they're doing dhikr of Allah. Now I'm dhikr of Allah, but individually, as for a group, that's not good, it's not from the Sunnah. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he spoke based upon knowledge. Subhanallah, he saw them doing dhikr. He didn't say, oh, mashallah, doing dhikr. No, ya akhi. Where do you get this wave? Because there's tariqa, your method of doing dhikr. Where do you get it from? In group. Where do you get it from? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Allah praised him. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ praised him. That's why, alhamdulillah, as-salafiyyun, Quran as-sunnah of the salaf. But as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, وَلَكِنْ أَكْثَرَكُمْ الْحَقِّ كَارِهُونَ. But a majority of people don't like the truth. Because the truth go against people's desires. The truth opposes our desires. The truth is heaven for our desires. So we have to fight against our desires to accept the truth. The truth will make us go against our own families. So either you have to choose your family or the truth. Barakallahu feekum. So we choose the truth. The Quran, the Sunnah, and the Salaf. So we live in a time when we call people the truth to Quran and Sunnah. They say you're either, what they call it, scholars for dollars, you're a Zionist. But if you call for bid'ah and shirk, they will praise you. Na'udhu billah min dhalik. That's why when Abu Sa'id, Abu Muhammad, Sa'id ibn Musayyib entered into the masjid, majority of you maybe don't know Sa'id ibn Musayyib. Sa'id ibn Musayyib, one of the great scholars of Islam. He was a student of Sahaba. He entered into the masjid after Fajr. He saw someone doing turaqah. He said, what are you doing? He said, ya Aba Muhammad, is Allah going to punish me because I'm praying? Look to the doubt. Look how Shaitan trying to justify his act, his action. He said, no, but Allah will punish you because you are opposing the sunnah, the method. Because Prophet Sallam warned us against praying sunnah when the sun is rising. Tayyib. So Abu Sa'id, Abu Muhammad Sa'id Musayyib, he was not deceived by saying, mashallah, yeah, you're right. No. Because two conditions, my dear brothers. Now, how many people will say to them, don't celebrate Prophet Muhammad's birthday? Tayyib, if you want to do the correct way, quote unquote, the correct way, fast every Monday. Fast every Monday. Prophet said when the man was asked him, say, oh, Messenger of Allah, what do you think about fasting Monday? He said, that day I was born and that day I received the revelation. So fast every Monday, not the bid'ah way. Likewise, they're celebrating Isra wal Mi'raj. Sahaba never did it. Tabi'in never did it. Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi, Hanbal never did it. So we have to stick to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Salaf. Barakallahu feekum. Because our deen is completed. Imam Malik said, nothing will rectify this ummah except that which rectified it in the beginning, which is what? Following the Quran, the Sunnah, and the way of the Sahaba. May Allah preserve them all. So my brothers, look at the bid'ah. Bid'ah starts small. Like now, you see how many people you see them just before Salat. You say salam to them, how are you, everything. After Salat finishes, he says salam alaikum. He starts shaking people's hands. Why are you doing this? This is not from the Sunnah, barakallahu feek. Except if you haven't seen the person before the Salat, say you say salam to him because I haven't seen him. But now it becomes like Sunnah way. Every time Salat finishes, assalamu alaikum. Yes, assalamu alaikum. Akhi, leave it, ya akhi. A person must say, what is the problem? You are just saying salam. The problem you are opposing the sunnah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the sahaba, after you finish the salat, say salam to each other. So now we go for the sunnah bi-idhnillah jalla wa ala. And we ask Allah to keep us firm upon the sunnah, even if the majority of people hate us. Because we love the sunnah more than anyone else, more than ourselves, more than our families. And we ask Allah to keep us firm upon sunnah al-Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. Because sunnah al-Mustafa is more beloved to us than anything else. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم تسليما كثيرا.